Was there an ice age? Hi, it's Calvin Smith here, and welcome to Creation Basics, where our goal is to make God's creation part of your everyday conversation. And today's question is, was there an ice age? Well, in addition to the biblical evidence, which we're going to touch on a little later on, there is plenty of physical evidence that would confirm that, yes, there definitely was an ice age. We've got gouged rocks that likely scraped together as glaciers grew, and we've got till deposits and moraines and large rocks sitting in the middle of empty fields that were likely dropped when glaciers retreated and melted. Sure, we believe there was an ice age, but the better questions are actually, when did it happen and how? You see, the evolutionary story usually references many ice ages, with at least five major ones over Earth's history. The oldest two ice ages, evolutionists claim, happened 2.3 billion and 770 million years ago, respectively. Currently, evolutionists believe that we're living in a warm interglacial period of an ice age, which supposedly began about 3 million years ago. Now, in contrast, young Earth creationists believe in just one ice age caused by Noah's flood. But what factors would cause an ice age? Well, a study done by secular scientists found that variations in the carbon balance between the atmosphere and the ocean could initiate ice ages and influence the timing of glacial-interglacial cycles. They further claim that volcanism and the shifting of the tectonic plates would result in movement of the continents. They feel that that could affect ocean and atmospheric circulation patterns. And although there's much speculation as to what triggered this, evolutionists are kind of at a loss to provide a satisfactory explanation. For example, if the sun was cooler in the past, well, you'd just get a frozen barren landscape, not glacial growth. Secular scientists don't have a mechanism for an ice age because the missing piece to their puzzle is contained within scripture. What you need is warm oceans and cool land masses. That's interesting because it's exactly what likely happened as a result of Noah's flood. The global flood of Noah's day was a worldwide catastrophe which changed the face of the planet forever and caused severe changes to the environment, including the carbon balance between the ocean and the atmosphere. These secular scientists unknowingly affirm the biblical flood model. So what's a good biblical flood model? Well, many creation geologists believe that when all of the fountains of the great deep burst forth in Genesis 7:11, that refers to the breaking up of the Earth's crust into plates initiating the flood. The breaking up of tectonic plates and their subsequent movement would have caused massive volumes of hot water and molten rock from the Earth's crust to flow into the ocean. The oceans would have continued to be warmed by volcanism and lava flows, and massive amounts of lava and volcanic ash are found within rocks laid down by the flood. This could have triggered the ice age because the ocean would begin to cool mainly through evaporation. The evaporation would add significant amounts of water vapor to the air and precipitate as heavy snow. So ice sheets could have built up thousands of feet thick in only a few centuries, not thousands to millions of years, according to computer models. After the flood, the Earth would have been unstable, so there was likely a lot of volcanism going on. The volcanic ash would have sped up the process of cooling the Earth post-flood because it would have pumped large amounts of dust and aerosols into the stratosphere, which could continue to float there for several years, which reflects sunlight back into space, acting as another cooling mechanism. Eventually, glacier maximum would have been reached where the oceans cooled enough to slow evaporation. The snow would have stopped and the ice would have begun to melt. And the whole process from a warm world at the end of the flood to the melting of ice would only take centuries of time. We further find evidence of a post-flood ice age recorded in scripture as Job makes many references to snow and ice, including God sending a downpour of snow, storehouses of snow and hail, and God bringing forth the ice and frost. Job 37, 9-10 says, "From its chamber comes the whirlwind and the cold from the scattering winds. By the breath of God, ice is given and the broad waters are frozen fast." So was there an ice age? Yes, but there was only one caused by the catastrophic flood of Noah's day. Not several, and it lasted centuries, not thousands of years. If you're appreciating this content, visit the answersingenesis.ca website for much more. Please consider donating to the ministry, and whatever platform you're accessing this on, it likely has some combination of features that allow you to subscribe or like or share, and we'd appreciate you taking the time to do so because it's probably the best thing you can do to help us continue to do outreach. Until next time, I'm Cal Smith. Blessings to you.